Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to Terratech Episode 3. I've made some changes to our vehicle. Well, not really changes, more like upgrades, I guess. Well, I guess upgrades are still changes to our vehicle since the previous episode. I went ahead and added all those plates to the side and gave ourselves some, like, little... I don't know. These look like butt cheeks to me when they're just on the back like this with the gap in the middle. Unfortunately, there's no one-wide plates, so we're just going to have to deal with that for now. I added a whole bunch more of the sort of... what are those called? The little, like, tractor beam things that hold on to items. Added another shield, because one shield was not big enough to cover our entire craft. Finished adding all the guns to the bottom there. Added four wheels on each side. So this is pretty much without... Oh, and added a bunch more batteries. Well, two more batteries. Doubled our batteries for double shields. And without, like, a significant redesign, this is basically... what our vehicle's gonna look like for now. I don't know if there's any, like, significant changes I could really do without getting new parts anyways. Alright, but as promised, we're gonna go after this quest in this episode. Also, I found that these geysers restore battery power really quickly. We're basically good on battery power, but I'll throw them on real quick just to get them topped off. But yeah, they're way faster than solar panels. Which is quite nice. Oh, come on, get down there. There you go. There we go. Yeah, and I just have our shields tucked underneath the craft, and then a solar generator down here too, in case we ever get stranded. We have it at least. Although, if at all possible, I'd like to avoid using it, which is why I added all the batteries. The extra pair of wheels doesn't really seem to do much. We still sometimes get stuck on the top of hills just because we're so wide. I would like... well, yeah, see, like, right there we got stuck a little bit. Would like a vehicle with a bit more clearance, although it's partially my fault because I added guns to the bottom here. But they do add a good chunk of firepower. However, for the time being, I'm just going to throw them up here. Just so we have a bit more clearance and we can actually... go places. Let's see, I'll just throw you there. Now we still have the solar panel hanging down, but that's not a big deal. Alright, there we go. Now we should get stuck at least a little bit less often. Although now we only have, like, what is that? What's 5 in the front? 4 above? Yeah, 9 lasers facing forward. Instead of 14. Should be fine, though, as long as we just pick our battles and fight enemies from far away. Alright, just give me these resources. Just plow right through them with the drills. Scoop everything up, because we can hold a ton of resources. We want to make this worth our time, after all. Although, who knows what we're going to find. Once we get closer to the crate... defeat enemy ambushers, so obviously there's going to be something. Once we get closer, I'm going to throw those guns back on the front, just so we have a bit more firepower. Also, apparently just having the shields on, even if they're not repairing, does slowly use battery power, so we'll just have to keep that in mind. Alright, there's the crate. Well, this is a fairly soft hill zone now, so let's go ahead and throw those guns back on front. Nice if you could sort of save configurations, but I can also understand why not. Hopefully you don't get motion sickness from this or anything. There we go. Okay. Let's deal with this ambush. Look, there's a delivery crate over there. Let's see what's in it. Well, let me get all these delicious crystals first. These are all worth a fair bit once they go through our refinery. We can hold so many! Nom 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 nom. I'm not forgetting those back there. I just want to break down all the crystals first. Now, in a perfect world, I would have one craft for fighting and one craft for sort of mass collecting like this. Although I'm doing my best to sort of hybridize this just because... oh no, okay, at least I grabbed that and not one of the blocks. just because I'd have to spend another like hour or hour and a half grinding up to get all the resources I need. Is there? Yeah. Be free, little green crystal. Oh, well, what's that noise? Let's get turned around. There's actually two enemies here. As long as we keep backing up, we should be okay. Actually, now they're focusing on each other. I thought they'd be strictly against me, but now they're also against each other. Good job. Yeah, that wasn't nearly as bad as I thought it was gonna be. Let's pop some more of these delicious crystals. Yeah, these drills are so nice. I think there's... No, did we? I guess we picked them all up. I thought one rolled away, but there's just the one right here. Scoop. And another green one over there. All right, let's see what's in the crate first, though. Oh, it's one of the sentry drone things or whatever. You can put like guns on it and stuff, and it'll defend. Okay, I'm definitely going to use that to defend my trading post. So I'll just throw that on the front here. This is a shield generator, right? Yeah. Okay. Need more of those. Although I really want to get the technology that I don't know what it's called, but I've seen it in videos. You can put on your craft, and it will actually take energy from nearby, like resources, and apply it to any batteries you have on your vehicle. So I don't need to keep taking off my batteries. I can just swing by a base, wait for a minute, and then and be good. Yeah, shields operate similar to repair bubbles, except they just prevent the shots from going through. Like, we can still shoot out, but enemy shots will get slowed down. Apparently, and do crafty business again or capture the enemy base. Let's go capture the enemy base. I want more base parts, and maybe there's a furnace over there we can smelt all this stuff into. Just so we can sort of offload without having to go back to our base. And man, this thing is so fat. There's the base. Oh, there's a lot of enemies guarding it, and there's a little guy right here with a little trike wheel in the front. That's adorable. Okay, he's gone. There's at least three enemies up here. Just shoot from a distance as we do. Righteous. Looks like there's actually kind of a big dude over there. How's that? I think that crystal got bugged out. Like, we were able to break it and get the resources from it, but it's still there, like the model is. But we can pass through it, no problem. Had that happen to me earlier with one of the rocks. Okay, it does look like there's a cellar in the middle there, so. Oh, it's the same. Nope. Stop trying to shoot the base. Looks like it's the same setup with just a bunch of refineries. But why are these not locking onto enemies? There we go. No, go away. There we go. What about you? Stop trying to shoot the base, dang it. Alright, all the base guardians are down. Congratulations, the base is yours. What's this? Oh, it's a filter. And oh, this is one of the production units. Right, okay. Alright, well, let's sell as much of this as we can, I guess. Just back up on it. Right, whatever, that's fine for now. We'll head back to base eventually. Where is Crafty Mike? Where's business? Let's see, capture the enemy base is back that way. Let's deroute this so it doesn't say player tech anymore. And Mike is also back this way. All right. We're just gonna head back this way, back towards our base. Picking up resources as we go. No, this is this the broken one? I think this is the glitched one. Yep, okay. That's fine. Oh, hello, Mr. Crafty Mike. What have you got for us today? Good to see you again, kiddo. Aw, shucks. It's your old pal, Crafty Mike. My base had another little accident. Maybe you could reattach that receiver for me. Sure, why not? Don't want to get too close to it, though. I don't want it taking my resources. So it's going to gather up all of those. If we take this off, does it drop everything? Yeah, it does. Okay. I was hoping we could take them off and set them down, because we have to get close to this to use it, or to do this quest. There we go. Silos are cool. They're basically like this, but they have a higher priority than the... What are these called? Well, I can't take it off now, but whatever those little grabbers are called. So they'll take items off the grabbers, but they won't give them back. And they're used for holding onto items for, like, crafting and stuff. So I learned how to use those furnace thingies. Not furnace, but the crafting station. It's really simple. You just put the items in there, click on the item that you want, and as long as it's connected, it'll, like... To make a GSO1 block, it takes one wood and one plumbite ore. There you go. Takes them from the nearby silo, tucks them up, scoops out the brick you made. Good job, kiddo! Why don't you keep on making blocks here for a while? Nah. Later, kiddo. Mission complete. Alright. Well, I'm not going to worry about taking that stuff. I just want to get back to base so I can sell off everything. Ah, home sweet home. That wasn't too bad. Scoop up some of these crystals as we go, since we're basically there. I don't really care if I lose a couple of them at this point. Because we're doing okay on money for now, until we have to finance a new vehicle. I think... That quest is pretty far out there, though. So I'm just gonna sell this stuff off, and then head out. Oh, and charge up my batteries, too. I didn't realize they were dead. That could have been bad. Oh, also, set this guy up. I totally forgot. Okay, can we... Actually, where is it? Oh, it got destroyed. I had a, geyser thing here. Didn't I? Oh no, never mind. It's on the other side. Derp. Got turned around. Do another pass by of this. Make sure those resources stay nice and loaded up. Okay, good enough. I want to see what I can do with this. Because if I could. Attach this to the geothermal thing? Because it says it's a rotating base, but I don't know what that means. Let me... Oh, that's weird. Like... Oh, okay, so we can put the drone up higher, and this will turn with the drone. Okay, I see. Where is that shield generator? There we are. I think I'm okay with just my repair things for now. Okay, we'll give him a solar generator. Pop that on there. Is that not okay? He's like upside down. What's going on there? Because that's there, or does it... Okay, that's why. Because I guess the angle of the solar panel takes priority. So is there any way to give this thing? Oh, no. Okay, that's weird. It was just like bugging out for some reason. All right, let's put this back down there. What are some guns we can add to it? Dang it, keep forgetting to add my batteries. Yeah, you'll see how quickly these get charged up. Even with four of them on there, which means it takes four times as long, it's still quicker than like one solar panel charging one battery. It's very nice. Speaking of batteries, I should add one to this guy so that way he can keep his shield through the night. Also, actually, I want to test something. Can I attach that to the cab over here that I threw down? I want to. There's all kinds of things I want to test out because I haven't gotten to mess with some things yet. So now you can have allies. Where's that cab? Here it is. I don't know if it needs a special cab or if it just needs that piece attached to the cab. Okay, pop you down there. You on top of it. Follow? Are you gonna follow me now? Oh, dude, that works. Oh, nice. Nice, 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 nice. Okay. I mean, you can't really see it because it's just a little cab, which is really slow, but you can see it like trying to turn and stuff. Here, let me move that for you, buddy. Look at it. Isn't that adorable? Just falls on its face. Okay, that's really good. I could actually attach. Like, I could create a second craft and then attach, like, the AI module onto this guy and then just tell this guy to follow me around or something. I don't know. We'll think of something. I'm gonna put this in a safe spot for now, though, along with this cab. Just so they don't get popped. There's so many like implications of what we could do. But for now, we will leave it. This thing has a mind of its own now. Not that it can really do anything, but right, so yeah, we're definitely gonna go capture the enemy base over there. Plunder whatever it may have for us. Unless it's useless stuff that we already have, slash don't need. Was barely able to get through that little incline. Once we get rolling, though, we're pretty set. Ooh, you have some big blocks. Anything we can use? Oh, your cab's right on the front, too. Easy pickings. Anything new? Does not look like it. Alright. Well, there's a little, like, light here. Few lights. Let's actually just put those on our bum. Alright, there we go. Fantastic. Exactly what I want in a craft. Alright, a bunch of enemies on the radar. And the base is just on the top of that dune over there, it looks like. See how these are the enemies guarding it for sure. Just to wait to get close enough for them, the AI to load in, and then they will hopefully attack each other at some point. Hey, you need to chill, bro. A trio drill, eh? Alright, get out of here. Later, nerd. Is that the base that's rotating? Or is it the. No, it's the regen point. Okay. I don't know why this specific enemy was marked though, since it's not the base. Okay, he's dead. All base guardians are down. Congratulations, the base is yours. What is this? 3-pound cannon? Yeah, I like those. They just pew-pew a little bit harder than the little machine gunny things do. And what is this? Another filter thing? Yeah, filter. Regen point. Oh, it has, what is this called? Let me just drop it. So, nope, stop, stop. Oh my gosh. There we go. The payload terminal. Yeah, so now we can buy items from anywhere. As long as we have the money for it, obviously. So if we just right-click on it... Oh, it has to be anchored, right? If we just right-click on it, it doesn't even need power. Now we can buy any item that we could normally... And it's not any more expensive, I don't think, than just buying it from a regular trade shop. Oh, it actually might be. Hold on. No, never mind. No, it's not. I just remember the prices of the wheels, but not much else. So, that looks good. Okay. Let's throw that back here for now. I guess we may as well, since these are expensive and we'll want them for expanding in the future. Or adding to our robot army. Alright, so there's another hostile tech group. Oh, this is for actually GSO, so we can level up and get more GSO stuff. Okay, let's go over there. It's already our current mission. 600 meters, so not too far. Oh, there's actually an invasion dropping in here. Let's go ahead and just skip by that. I just want to get doing quests, because as we get quests give us experience, and experience gives us levels, and levels give us more gear and equipment. Ooh, well, whatever, I guess we can power that third shield, it doesn't really matter. Hey, how far away is it? Or about halfway there. Okay, not too much further then. Grab these sweet crystals. I don't think the bigger crystals give you, like, more resources. But I could be wrong. As I oftentimes am. Also, I'm not sure why sometimes the platforms don't always pick up the items right away. And you have to manually add them. Ooh, okay, there's some more of the GSO core guys. Well, that guy actually has sort of a tilted down bot. It's funny looking. Ooh, he has a lot of guns on him. Alright, we're gonna be backing up. Because we have our regen shield things, but those only last as long as our batteries do, and if they're repairing, they use up more battery power, so we still want to minimize damage as much as possible. Yeah, very nice. Anything useful in there? Got some more lights. Oop. Why does that one light up? These don't. Oh, now they do. That's actually kind of annoying. Can I... Okay, we're gonna get rid of them. Not worth the headache. Alright, and you're the last guy, I think. Although you are firing at someone up on the hill. Oh, that could be a coincidence. You can see our 3-pound cannon firing those arcing shots. Let's put it in a bit of a better spot. Okay, that was the last enemy we needed to destroy. Though there is one more right here, and he's now gone. Okay, so a strut, a little laser, and a... whatever this is. Fixed anchor. Oh, you're not dead yet. When you're effectively dead, you just have two little beam guns on you.
Die!
Now we have another quest with Crafty Mike, Crafty Business 3, and capture another enemy base. Okay, let's do Crafty Business 3, although it's 800 meters out, just to give us some more experience with the base corporation. I don't remember what it's called. GSO, I guess. Alright, so this crafting mech tutorial and anything beyond it is basically all foreign to me, because I've only done up to the previous one. Oh no, I did this filter one too, I think this is the last one I've done though. I'll just let him read out. There you go. Set it for wood now. Yeah, filters can be really useful. I mean, for obvious reasons, but just in case you don't get it. So that you can put all items in one area, and then as they go down the line, they'll get filtered out by their typing. And then placed in certain areas. So if you want to have separate resource pools, you can do that. Or if you want to sell some items but you want to hold on to others, you can do that too. Like in this case, you can put all your items here, it'll take the wood, pull it into the furnace, which will then create power. I'm not sure how long a furnace runs off of one wood, but it is enough to get full battery charge on two batteries at least. That's pretty cool. Then it shows the example here where the wood will go down that way, but everything else will go down to the silo. I'm gonna steal this stuff. My money. I'm gonna grab these batteries too. Once he lets me, anyway. Hold over the fuel, okay. Give me this, thank you. This. Here, I'll take this too. And I will not keep your base powered. I'm gonna take the shield and the batteries and then be on my way. Okay, give me this. Q. There. Alright, good enough. After the main base, that's 1.2 kilometers out, so that's a ways away. Got two random GSO blocks for that, so it's not vital. But it could be important. But I think I'm going to call that an episode for today, guys. I'm just going to head back to base and sell off all this stuff. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.